Hello, folks. There's no folks yet, but in faith I believe. Happy, let's see, what is this? It's October 1st. Is it Thursday? I think it's Thursday, October 1st, 2020. And probably many folks are, hopefully many folks are finishing up the first video in a seven-part series that I recorded with Don Reid of the Statler Brothers. And no doubt many folks are probably watching that now, and they'll join us a little bit later on the Facebook Live program. And no doubt for days, weeks to come, there'll be many thousands that will view this series. I have a tickle in my throat. I don't have anything to drink. So we'll wait a little bit though, just in case some folks are watching the video and finishing the video. We posted it right at 7 o'clock, but you can listen to it anytime. So some folks probably started at 7:01, some 7:05, 7:05, 7:10. Maybe some are starting now. Some will watch it tomorrow, next week. But we'll wait, because here in a little bit, I'm going to feature some of the great gospel music of the Statler Brothers, and we'll have a little fun with some of the Statler Brothers stuff I'm going to do as well in tonight. So we'll wait just a little bit, okay? Let me get some of my commercials out of the way. What do you say? I tell you what. Hold on. I need a drink of A&W root beer, Diet A&W. Chase this tickle out of the way. That's about all I have in there is about a drink, so I hope it lasts. Okay, so if any of you are new kind of to my Facebook Live, you know at the beginning, I kind of do some commercials and get some things out of the way. And so I'm going to do that right now. We want to remind you that December 7, 8, and 9, we will be doing Christmas camp meeting in the Smokies. And there you see myself and the Old Time Preachers Quartet and Barry Rowland and Deliverance and Bob Sellers and Sacred Harmony and Sherry Taylor and Chelsea Estes, Paul Boland. And been in the studio all day with Paul right there. Been working on his new record. We did vocals all day long. And he knocked it out of the park, man. He did great, like he always does. But we'd love to have your senior adult Sunday school class come to the Smokies on that Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, December 7, 8, and 9, so you don't have to miss any church. You don't have to miss a Sunday. We're going to eat, and we're going to sing, and we're going to eat, and we're going to sing. We're going to eat, and we're going to preach. And then after we sing and we preach, we're going to eat. And then before we sing and we preach, we're going to eat. Are you picking up on the theme? So here's the number for more information. It is 865-278-3681. We would love to have you. Okay, don't forget, right there, Facebook Live with Les here. Wait a minute, let me get my chubby face up there and my glasses. And my eyes all cross-eyed, and my headphones there, and my microphone, and all the equipment, and all the bumper stickers on there. It says Les or Butler Music Group and Family Music Group, my companies, and Facebook Live with Les, Southern Gospel Music Memorabilia, Memories and Ministry. And you can go to butlermusicgroup.com and go to the store and get yourself a mug, and it helps us to pay for a bunch of this stuff that I'm having to do all of this for you. And so we would appreciate it if you would check that out. Okay, and also while you're there at the store, don't forget that you can pre-order my brand new CD, which we finished today. Whew. We've been almost a year. I work with a bunch of folks, and I always put them before my own music. And so it's just taken months longer. It was supposed to be out like April or May, and here we are in October. But all good. I'm glad that God has given us great folks to work with, and that we're busy in making music, gospel music, to take it to the world. And so it's all good. But while you're there at the store getting a mug, go ahead and you can get the pre-order of my new CD. Matter of fact, when you get there, there's a little clip of that new song that I did called That's My Preacher for all my preacher friends. Boy, I tell you, it's just a great song. Not that it's great because I do it. It's just Stephen Phillips just forevermore wrote a great, great song right there. And it aptly talks about the life of a preacher. So check that out. And let's see, we've got the Diamond Awards. So let me run that by you. If you want to go to Scoops Magazine and to the Diamond Awards. And I haven't forgotten. We're going to talk Don Reed and Statler Brothers here in a little bit. But I got to get my commercials out of the way. You can go to Google Scoops Magazine. Okay, Google Scoops Magazine. And there on the main page, it'll say Diamond Awards. When you click on that, there's a bunch of the folks that I work with that are up for Diamond Awards. And would you be kind enough to go there and vote for them? It'd be a blessing to them, and I would appreciate it. So if you see the name, last name Williamson anywhere, they're up for 4 awards. Lisa Williamson's up for 1, the group's up for 3 others. So you see Williamson, vote. If you see Rodney, Roger, or Debbie Johnson, or Heaven's Mountain Band in the bluegrass categories, they made the top 5 in 4 categories, vote. Okay, and then we've got Heart to Heart. They're up in a category. Vote for them. And then I was very blessed and very honored to be nominated in the J.D. Sumner Living Legend Award. And when my wife found that out, all she did was fall on the floor and laugh. And I understand. To consider me as a living legend is, well, it's just silly. But I guess a lot of folks thought that of me, and I'm honored, and I appreciate it, and thank you. So if you want to vote for all my friends there, just do a Google search for Scoops Magazine on the main page where it says Diamond Awards. Click on that, and then just vote in all those categories. If you vote for my friends, that would be a wonderful thing. All right, let's see, and we've got, okay, now if you like quartet music, and you probably do, because you're on here with me tonight celebrating the gospel music of the Statler Brothers. And many of you, I hope, saw the first of a 7-part series of my videos posted at 7 Central, 8 Eastern tonight. And it just concluded. If you like that kind of quartet music, I want to invite you to Dollywood on October 28th. That's the day that the Old Time Preachers Quartet, my quartet, will be there singing, and we're going to bring it to you. Mike Holcomb, arguably the greatest bass singer to ever walk on a stage, for my 2 cents. You need to come and hear him just tear up some bass singing, and just good old 4-part harmony, good old gospel music. And so we would love to have you at Dollywood as we are featured there on October 28th. Okay, so there's all of the commercials, I think, out of the way. So now let's see who's on here with us, and we're going to talk about that video. We're going to talk Don Reed and the Statler Brothers, and I've got some songs and a little something else that we're going to be playing for you here in just a little bit. But let's see who's with us. Oh, my Aunt Sue. She was the first one. Way to go, Aunt Sue. Number one today. Vic Zabelka from Chicago. Good to see you, Vic. Robert Hoskins. Hey, brother Mark Stroud. Are you still there, Mark? Man, we had a great time Sunday at church, didn't we? The Primitive Quartet just sang the glory down. And, just great preaching, and just all of it is wonderful. And we just went to church, and I like it like that. Sharon Ostrander, Patty Graham from Ohio, Jerry Manley, Patty Graham again. Hey, Langdon. So Don's son is on here with us. And I hope your dad's with you, hanging out. I hope you enjoyed the first part of that series. And I tell you what, folks, jot this down. I'm going to give you all the dates for the next part of the series here, okay? So the next one is going to be next Tuesday, October 6th. Tuesday, October 6th. And that will be at 7 p.m., okay? Central Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, okay? And so that'll be the second part of the 7-part series. Let's see here. Tim Gould. Hey, it's fat. Never mind. Now, Tim, I don't know where you're going with that. Watch it, Tim. Hey, we're mastering your record tomorrow, Tim, just so you know. Loretta Sanders Hall. Hello. So we got Verna and Patsy and Linda and Steve and Ellen and Wyatt and JC and Kathy and Brian, Epinette and Keith and Rich and Arlene and Jim. Hello, Les. Good to see you there. Wes, Terry and Edmondson and Harold. We got a bunch of folks. We got Rachel and Joe and Don Anderson. Good to see you, Don. Well deserved, my friend. Well, Don, you're way too kind there, but I appreciate you saying that. And Jim said, you're deserving, Les. Oh, you people. Thank you. John, Patty, and okay, Patty says the voting ends on October 5th. So you got to get those votes in the next 4 days. Would you please do that and vote for my friends in the Diamond Awards? Again, just Google Scoops Magazine, and it'll take you right to the main page on their online page, and it'll say Diamond Awards. Click on that, and then just do what it says. It'll take you 2 minutes. Bucky and Jimmy and Susan and Michael, and Jimmy says, bring it. Okay, now what's this? Les, you burst my bubble tonight. I thought I was the only one who had everything the Statler brothers ever recorded. David, no, man, I got it all. You're looking at Statler Brother fan number uno right here. I can sing baritone today, and I sing baritone in my own quartet because of the music of the Statler Brothers, because of all of that duo stuff. Just about every single song had either at least a duo line, but tons of verses where there was just two parts. And your old buddy Les figured out where to lock into that third part, and it taught me how to sing baritone. My mom sang alto, which is kind of the baritone part. So I learned from my mother at church, standing next to her, singing out of that Redback hymn book, and then the Statlers doing the duet stuff, and I put that third part in. Oh, Statler fan number one. Hello, Renetta. Hello, James. Eagle Lake, Florida. Good to see you. Tim Gould, that was a line from Fat Albert referring to me. Oh, yeah, okay. I'm with you, Tim. Let's see. There's Dorothy and Loretta from Winchester, Virginia. Good to see you, Loretta. I think, Loretta, did you text me and you couldn't get on and couldn't figure out the video? I think that was you, and I hope you figured it out. Hello, Jeff. Hello, Mike. Hello, Laura. Looking forward to the interview. I just studied and summarized the Statler Brothers this summer. Have 10 CDs, 7 DVDs, 9 books by Don. Oh, it's good stuff, Laurie. You're going to enjoy every second of it. Ruth and Jean and all kinds of folks here. Well, good to see everybody. All right, what do you say? We'll talk about Don and the Statler Brothers, and I want you to jump in too tonight. But let's go ahead and play one of the songs, shall we? Let me see. I've got some vinyl here. We're going to be looking at vinyl tonight. There's the Thank You World vinyl. And one of the songs, now what we're going to do after every video in the entire 7-part series, we are going to come back after the video plays, just like tonight, and I'm going to come back live, Facebook Live, and then we're going to play songs that we talked about in that video. Now tonight, we didn't talk about a lot of songs. We did this one, I'm getting ready to play, And then in the next video we're doing, we talked about a lot of songs. So I want to steal some from the next video to play tonight. And then we're still going to have plenty of music to play after the next video, which is next Tuesday night. But the one song that we did talk about was a song called The Blackwood Brothers by the Statler Brothers. And what a unique song. Well, first you can tell by the title. The title is The Blackwood Brothers by the Statler Brothers. What a unique title, which of course the Statler Brothers were known for those just unique titles, unique songs. They came at you from a different place, a different angle, and their gospel music was the same way. So what do you say? We listen to that one right now. We'll come back and we'll talk about some Statler Brothers stuff and then get something else ready for you to play. But for those of you who are new, I'm updating and working on a ton of stuff, none of which is done, so I'm still very archaic in my delivery, but we have fun anyway. And so my turntable's over here, and it's like over my head. So whenever I'm having to play vinyl, I got to skip around until I figure out where the groove is. But hey, man, you know, It gets the job done, and we have fun doing it. So here we go. The Blackwood Brothers by the Statler Brothers.
We all four grew up together in a small Virginia country town. And for some strange reason, God only knows, we got to singing around. National Guard Armory or the old schoolhouse we go see. The Blackwood Brothers who were coming to town to sing especially for me. They always drew a crowd of young folk and old women and men with the mortgage.
There's one of those duos I was telling you about.
Farmers and teachers, rich men and preachers, the old schoolhouse was full and they would come. And we'd fold up every album, every picture, every single. Their autographs were the only things free. But the main thing they were selling was Jesus and good singing. In that old schoolhouse where the Blackwoods sang for me. And they would sing,
and they would sing.
Love it.
Like the old West Rock of Ages, every day will be Sunday by and by. Heavenly love inside the gate, give the world a smile each day. They were all peace like a river.
Song I like. First off, you know, you gotta love the four-part harmony, but that duo, I told you, duos, man, they did them just about every song. I learned how to sing baritone from the Statler Brothers. It's just the way it is. But didn't you like how they incorporated some of those old Blackwood Brothers songs in on that? And then they did the that old upright piano, like they used on the last song of every show on their television show. That old upright. Cool stuff, wasn't it? The Blackwood Brothers by the Statler Brothers. So here we are after the airing of the first video of the seven-part series with Don Reid of the Statler Brothers. And as promised, we are featuring the gospel music of the Statler Brothers. And we're going to have another gospel tune come up here in a minute. But before we do that, we got something that's not a gospel tune. And really, it's not even a tune. You'll see what I mean in a minute. But let's see who else we've got on here. And let's talk Statler Brothers. So let me see. Let me ask you a question. How long have you been a Statler Brother fan? When did it first hit you? When did you first hear the Statler Brothers sing and go, oh, I like that? Type it in there. We'll see. Hello, Terry. Hello, Marcia. Hello, Ricky. Jim says, now that's cool. There's Janie. Crosby, Minnesota. Minnesota, that's a long way away from where I am. I'm in Nashville. Ron and Marlene's from Northeast Missouri. Good to see you, Marlene. And if many of you are have come in because you are tied to one of the Statler Brother Facebook pages or websites or something, we welcome you if it's the first time you've been here with me on Facebook Live with Les. And it's the subtitle is Southern Gospel Music, Music, Memorabilia, Memories, and Ministry. And this is this series, this seven-part series we're doing, is a bit unique in that we're going to what is commonly looked at as a secular group, the Statler Brothers. But my goodness, after I started doing all the research, they did as much gospel as they did Southern gospel or country music, and I have played the gospel music of the Statler Brothers on all of my radio shows, going back for 42 years. And we talk about that in an upcoming video. So I won't let the cat out of the bag there. But we welcome you. And it's not every night, but about 4 or 5 days out of the week, we just gather together and we play old gospel music and tons of quartet stuff, including the Statler Brothers. And I talk about, I've been doing this for 42 years, ran the Singing News Magazine for several years and the Solid Gospel Radio Network for about 20, been on the radio for 42 years, hosting TV shows for years. And so I've got tons of memorabilia. I've got a hall of fame, basically, that stuff that I own. And so we go on at night and I typically show some memorabilia and I have a story about the artist or the group or the songs, and we just have a good time. And then I always end it with some kind of ministry thing. And it can be everything from asking for prayer requests, or I tie in scripture to a song that we've played, and I'm going to do that here a little bit later on. And so it's what we do. So we invite you to come any time that I'm on and just join in. And sometimes we do requests. And in the last few days, I've been using this right here, the Singing News flashback trivia card deck, and we've been doing some trivia things and been just having an absolute ball. And we invite you to do that when we're on, okay? Now, all right, let's keep going here. Let's see what we've got. We got Kathleen, and Jim says, 42 years, I told you you were a legend. No, I'm just old, Jim. 42 years doesn't mean that I've done anything good. It just means that I'm old. There's Robert and Brenda and Francis and Heath and hello, Terry Carter. Good to see you, sir. Ron Barnett goes back to, with the Statler Brothers, back to 69 or 70. And that's about for me, too, back during the Johnny Cash days on the TV show. So I'm about there with you. And there's Parky Lisa and Laura says, when I lived in Stanton and had a next-door neighbor who went to Olivet Presbyterian Church in the mid-70s. And so they're from the Statler Brothers' hometown. What about that, Laura? That's cool. Statler Brothers, born and raised right there in Stanton and never moved. Isn't that a cool thing? Let's just talk about that for a second. I mean, they were big. I mean, they won any and every kind of award, from Grammys to, you know, the CMAs, all that kind of stuff. They were a big deal. Man, they could have moved to Nashville or New York or Hollywood or whatever, but they stayed right there in Stanton, Virginia. And I'm telling you, I love that about them. I love that about them. Similar thing with Bill and Gloria Gaither. They live in the same house that they bought, I think it's in 1960, in Alexandria, Indiana. And they could go anywhere, do anything, and live anywhere. They live on an island if they wanted to. They stay right there in their hometown. I just love that. I love that. Let's see, David, fan since 10 years old, 75 or 66. Okay, that's good. My aunt says, as long as I can remember. Yeah, that's about me. Loretta says, when I was about 15. All right. Hello to Brenda. Hello to Pat. Hello to Lori. Jim says about 1975. That's, of course, when all the Pistons were really firing with the Statler brothers. Terry says, howdy, okay. So let me see who else has jumped on here. Patty Graham, as long as I can remember. There's Tom Rusk. Hello, old Tom. My old buddy from South Carolina. Doing your always fine job, Les. Well, thank you, Tom. I appreciate it. Enjoying the great program. I hope you got to see the video with me and Don. What impressed me about Don's books were the brotherly love expressed. Buddies became spiritual brothers. Yes, yes, I agree with that. And hello, Cindy. Okay, so, all right, so maybe we'll ask another Statler brother question here in a little bit. But now on Tuesday, we touch on their alter egos. You say, what now? Now, if you're a Statler brother fan, you know where I'm going. Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys. You got to do it like that. Cadillac Cowboys. And so, I'm going to play some Roadhog for you tonight. And if you have never been exposed to Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys, all I can say is sit back. Don't be standing because you are liable to fall over in the floor. You better sit down and then turn up your computer or TV or whatever you're watching this on and get ready to just absolutely laugh your socks off. Now, I'm going to play the very first piece. They did an entire album, and we'll at some point we'll probably get into some of that right there. There they are. Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys live at the Johnny Mac Brown High School. Right there. We're not playing that tonight. We're going to go to the thing, the piece that they did before that, that led to this complete album of comedy from the Statler Brothers, a.k.a. Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys. And it happens to be on this album here, the Statler Brothers Country Music, right there. So the very first piece they did, and right there is a picture, let me get a close-up there, of Lester Roadhog Moran, that's Lester right there, and his Cadillac Cowboys. There's Red and Wesley, two young country singers. And there's Wichita, his takeoff lead guitar player. And it's just great stuff. So I'm gonna play just the opening of the radio show on, are you ready for the call letters? I'll let the Roadhog tell you. It's just too good. And then I'll let them kick off into their little musical piece of Little Liza Jane. And then we're going to end with their version of the great gospel song, Angel Band. Now, are you sitting down? I'm going to give you 5 more seconds. Sit down. Turn it up. And let me try to find the groove on this. Oh, my goodness, help me, Lord. Here we go.
You're listening to WEAK Radio, the weak voice of Rainbow Valley, where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day. The correct Rainbow Valley time is...
Listen to this.
About 9:35 a.m. and FM. The local Rainbow Valley news and weather report is very bad.
Very bad.
The unofficial temperature outside our studio window is 4 degrees.
Listen to the high.
With expected highs tonight of 95.
Okay.
And now for your Saturday morning listening pleasure, WEAK presents another week program. Lester Moran, the old Roadhog, and his Cadillac Cowboys.
So you gotta go with... I've played in some church bands just like this.
Thank you.
Hey, hey, and howdy to everybody out there in radio land.
All right.
Here's Lester Moran, old road hog, and his Cadillac Cowboys. Mighty neighborly ugly, let us in your living room for the next 15 minutes. A good old country music.
All right. Now, there, I'm giving you a little, just a little hit, because if you have too much road hog, you could end up in the hospital tonight, and we don't want to hurt you. We're not here to hurt you. We're here to help you tonight. So I don't want to give you too much. And don't forget, you know, in Proverbs, what it says, a merry heart, what's it say? A merry heart doeth good like a medicine. So we're going to get some laughing in tonight. And aren't you glad that we can laugh during all of the insanity of what's going on in this world today, that we can put on a little Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys and just have a good laugh. We're having a good laugh tonight. Merry heart doeth good like a medicine. Now, okay, now let me see if I can find our gospel song from Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys. And if you know it, you can sing along with it. Now, you're going to have to bear with me. I've already told you now, if you're new to me, my turntable's up over my head. I'm working on fixing all of this, but you gotta bear with me, okay? All right, hold on now. I'm getting close. We're getting close. All right, here we are.
Mighty fine. Thank you very much. I always enjoy doing that for all you folks out there. Well, it's sacred time on the show.
Sacred time.
Like to send this one out this morning to all our sick and shut-in friends. This is the time of the show when the boys take off their hats and gather around the microphone for an old-time hymn. One this morning called Angel Band. Goes something like this.
Sing along with him now.
Saturday morning. Wichita, take us out of here now.
Get it, witch.
Don't forget us each and every Saturday night. That's the Johnny Mike Brown High School. And don't forget to come by and see Burford. That's Burford's Barbershop out on Big Tree Road.
Little Burford.
If you can grow it, Burford can
clip it.
See you back here next week, same time, same station. Until then, it's the old road hog and the Cadillac Cowboys saying, see you back here next week, same time, same station. Until then, it's the old road hog saying, be good to your neighbor. Drive careful. May the good Lord take a liking to you.
Witch.
Like you to make people like me live and let live. Don't take no wooden head.
I tell my daughter-in-law that all the time.
Put your best foot forward. You lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink.
This has been another week program from WEAK Radio.
You never get too old
for more of the same.
If a shoe
fits, wore it.
A man that don't lie ain't got nothing to say.
That's my
Bernie
favorite one.
Are we all?
Are we all? Oh, then he gets to coughing good. Okay, come on now. You know, this is the most fun you've had in forever right there. Lester Roadhog Moran is Cadillac Cowboys on WEAK Radio. All right, you boys. Okay. Oh, man. Here's another. I'm going to show you another picture of them. Here they are live at the Joni Mack Brown High School. Right there. Look at there. Look at that bus of theirs. Okay, wait a minute. Let me see. Let me find this other picture here for you. You're going to love this. Okay. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, it must be on one of the other albums. The album that they did ended up going plywood. And they got a plywood award. Oh, okay. I can't find it. I'll find it and show you later. But Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys simply can't be beat. Now listen. Oh, I've got breaking news. I need that Fox News, you know, yeah, what they do on Fox News, breaking news. Langdon, if you're watching, I sent you an email today, but they made reference to it in the book, and on one of the upcoming video interview shows, we talk about the fact that there are some outtakes of Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys that didn't make the album, and nobody's heard them. Now, your old buddy Les is doing everything he knows to do to bribe Landon Reid, Don's son, to get me some of those. Now, if he gets it to me and he says I can't play it on any of my shows, then I won't, because I'm a man of my word. I will not do that. But if he gets it to me and he gives me the green light to share them with some folks, I'll let you know. I'll keep you posted. But if there's some outtakes that I get to hear, I'll be the happiest man in the world. Because right there, a merry heart doeth good like a medicine. And Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys. That's good medicine right there. Okay, now, we're going to play, what are we going to play? I forgot what I was going to play on this one. Oh, yeah, okay. We're going to do this right here. This is a great traditional Southern Gospel quartet tune, and it's on the album Interview, and I'll show you that here in just a moment. Let me find it here on the old vinyl. Okay, it's cut number 3. I mean, this right here is quartet 101. This is quartet is what I'm saying. Southern Gospel Quartet. If you pull up Southern Gospel Quartet in the dictionary, it'll probably have this song right here mentioned in it, and the arrangement of it and everything. And now and Don talks about this, I think, in next week's show. But again, we talked about so much music in next week's show that I can't play it all next week. So I'm pre-playing some of the songs, and this is one of them. But he said that they took the exact arrangement of the Blackwood Brothers and just recorded it with the Statler Brother vocals on a song called Every Day Will Be Sunday By and By. So we're gonna play that minute. But let's see who else is on here with us. We'll talk a little bit, and then we'll play another one of those songs there. All right, let's see who we got. We got Gail, and we got Cindy, and we got Jerry Minor. We got Tyler and Carol and Peggy and Karen and Jana. And Larry and Ann and Jerry Fellows, love it. Yeah, you know you loved Roadhog now. Richard and Loretta and Gary Kahn. Gary, that's funny stuff, isn't it? It's funny stuff. Oh, man. If the shoe fits, wore it. I tell my daughter all the time when I'm leaving, I said, don't take any wooden nickels. I stole that from Roadhog. Moth must have jumped off of that one. It's so old. Oh, no. I keep them nice and fresh, Sue. There's Steve, and there's Vanessa and Janice, and I remember Mother and Daddy singing that one. Oh, the old gospel song there that we played. Yeah, okay. Hey, Miss Sherry. Sherry Taylor, I bet you're ready to sign them up. Man, if Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys were still around, your old buddy Les would sign them up, and we would produce an album for the ages. Terry, I knew you'd love that, man. Jim says, great stuff, just like this, that shows how much you love doing what you do, brother. Well, Jim, I do. I do, and I can't hide it. Mary Lou, there's old Bob Rogers. Good to see you, Bob. Long time no see, my brother. Kara and Tamara. And Don said it used to tear up Harold's voice when he did Lester. I bet it did. Because I do it some, and I can't do it long because it does that. It tears it up. Brenda McGloon, what a hoot. I told you, Brenda, Melody, and there's Sue. 63, I got my first radio. I'd play it all night after I went to bed. WLS in Chicago. I remember it well, Sue. There's Stanley and Patty and Jim and Marilyn and Elvis and Edith. And David says, would you do the Roadhog and Flowers on the Wall? I doubt it. And yes, we will always do it. Okay, Sherry and Jeff and Ellen. And there's Jeff says, my parents took me to South Plains Fair in Lubbock, Texas, where the Statlers were headlining in 1984. I was six. How cool is that? Hello, Roy. Hello, Ron. All right, so let's just keep going here. So let's talk some more Statler Brothers before I play that song. Hello there, Brother Hamlin. Good to see you, sir. We're having a good time tonight. You need to go back and listen to what I just did because, as you well know, a merry heart doth good like a medicine. And so I played some comedy from a group called Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac Cowboys. And they did their version of O Come Angel Band on WEAK Radio, Week Radio. Get it, Brother John? And so, you'll laugh, brother. It is hilarious. But let's keep talking here. Let's keep talking. So, all right, since we're talking about the gospel music of the Statler Brothers, y'all tell me your favorite gospel song by the Statler Brothers. Type it in there. And I'm getting ready to play the one that's going to be on next week's video show. And then we're going to call it a night. But just out of curiosity, would like to know your favorite Statler Brother gospel song, and maybe next week we'll try to slide one of them in there if we don't hit it next week, because again, next week's video show that I do with Don talks a lot about music, and we play have a lot of music to do. All right, yeah, Brother John, go back and watch it. You're gonna laugh. A Place Called Calvary. Okay, Loretta, all right, that's a good one. Amazing Grace, All Day Every Day. You cannot beat Amazing Grace. Amen, amen, and amen. And I think in the last video show, Don talks about Amazing Grace. And it's really, you'll enjoy what he's going to say about that and how it tied into the Statler Brothers. Well, I don't want to give it away. You need to watch the seventh part of the series. But don't forget, mark down next Tuesday at 7 Central, 8 Eastern, October 6th. That'll be the second of the seven-part video series that we are doing with Don Reid of the Statler Brothers. I love their version of Noah Found Grace in the Eyes of the Lord. We will play that on one of the shows, I promise you. And if I forget, somebody remind me, okay? That is a great one. They do a great version of that. That's a challenging song to do because of all the dialogue that's involved. But man, they kill it on that. Has to be Amazing Grace due to their history with it. Oh yeah, Tim. Okay. All right. Yeah. Amazing Grace. I also love their version of In the Garden. It's such a unique version, David. Their version of In the Garden is absolutely fantastic. Yep. Might have to do that one. Love them and send me a link. I usually, on nights at school, we'll soon be done with troubles and trials. We'll soon be done. Good song. There's Mickey watching. Okay, so keep typing while we listen to. We're going to go to the interview record, which right here is the, right there's the album cover. And we're going to go to the Blackwood Brother arrangement and the Statler Brothers singing Every Day. Will be Sunday, by and by. Let me see how close I can get to it here on the old Victrola. And we'll get close. Here we go. This is Quartet Singing 101 right here.
By and by, when a regenerate, that moment will be yours. down and pull on the long white robe. Sit down beside my Lord, and every day will be Sunday by and by.
I got sins to prophesy. Every day will be Sunday by and by.
Recognize as Sunday, the Lord's Day, because there's going to be one day there and not a bunch of days, because there's never going to be any night there. And the reason for that is because of the Lord. His light is going to shine and never shine out and never go dark. And we got one day, one big old day that we're going to have in eternity that's going to be wonderful and glorious, and we get to worship the Lord and see friends and loved ones who've gone on before, and get to eat and not have to gain any weight, not have to count carbs. Oh, I'm starting to preach now. Somebody say amen to that. Now, look at here. This is Facebook Live with Les, Southern Gospel Music, Memorabilia, Memories, and Ministry. So I want to hit you here with some Bible, and then we're going to still talk to you folks for a little bit. Then we're going to call tonight, and I want you to mark your calendars for Tuesday, October 6th, 7 o'clock, the second of the seven-part series with Don Reid. The video will be there for you to watch. And by the way, hit share on this one with the music that we're playing, and hit share on the first video, the first of the seven-part video that hopefully you watched before you joined me on the Facebook Live. It's on my Facebook page, Les Butler. If you didn't watch it, when we're done here tonight with the live, go back and watch my interview with Don and share, so all of your friends who are Statler Brother fans and friends will be able to watch it, okay, and do that for the whole series. Now, Revelation 21, we're going to go there and let's see, we'll start with verse 23. And the city had no need of the sun, that's what I was just talking about, neither the moon to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. And the nations of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it, and the kings of the earth do bring their glory and honor into it. And the gates of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no night there. Did you get that? There'll be no night there. One long day, every day, will be Sunday, by and by, the Lord's day, because the Lord is lighting it up. He is illuminating that city. And so it will be the Lord's day, all day, one day. Amen. And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. Aren't you glad for that day, that every day that's going to be Sunday by and by, that on that day, there'll be no more things that defile anything, no more abomination, no more lies, no more deceit, no more the junk that we have to live through and go through every day, especially during these days. Isn't that a great thing? No more, not over there, not in heaven, on that one and great, glorious, never-ending, no darkness day. And Revelation 22 says, and he showed me a pure river of water of life as crystal proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. And in the midst of it, the street of it, and on either side of the river was there the tree of life, which bare 12 manners of fruits and yielded her fruit every month. and the leaves of the tree which were for the healing of the nations. And there shall be no more curse during that one day that's all day. Isn't that wonderful? But the throne of God and the Lamb shall be in it, and the servants shall serve him. And they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their foreheads. And there shall be no night there. And they need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign forever and ever. No night there, only day, one day. No more calendars, no more clocks, no more watches, no more timepieces, no more alarm clocks, no more anything having to do with time. You know why? Because there'll be no time there. Every day will be Sunday, by and by. Statler's had it right with that one right there. If you love the Statler brothers and you don't have this, whatever you do, go get it tonight. Go get it. The Statler Brothers, an anthology. The music of the Statler Brothers, an anthology. Don Reid. And somewhere during the series, we will have another Statler with us as well. Just so you know. So this is going to be a great seven-part series. I hope you've enjoyed it tonight. Let's go on here and see who else is with us. Patty says, hallelujah, praise the Lord. That's right. That's right. That's in the book of Revelation. It's there to stay. Ruth Ann Brewster, good to see you, Ruth Ann. There's Matthew, and there's Ron again. Amen. Lisa and TJ and Ann and Cindy and Joyce and Gerald and Terry and Betsy. And Brenda wants to hear Life's Railway to Heaven. It's a good one. Might have to do that one. There's Ron, looking forward to it. Can't wait. Sydney. Hey, Brother Les, good to see you, Sydney. Hello, Mary. Hello, Jerry. Hello, Ron. Hello, Jerry again, and Don, and Diane, and Debbie, and Jerry again. And boy, we got all kinds of Jerrys. Hands down, the best. Yeah, we love the Statler Brothers. Love Daddy Sing Bass. Did you know that that was a Johnny Cash hit? And do you know who was singing with Johnny at that time? That's right, that would be the Statler Brothers. And they are on that multi-million selling record, Daddy Sang Bass. Pretty cool. Jay, there's Lenora saying, they always have been and always will be my favorite. Well, of course, Lenora. I agree. Don't know that I have a favorite. I love gospel and the harmony, and especially the way they sang everything. You know it, Ron. You know that's right. I'm agreeing with you, sir. There's Jerry and Vance and Mary, and Tom says, how great thou art. Boy, their version of how great thou art is. It's special. Lenora and Mickey and, okay, so there you go. So, what do you think, folks? Did we have a good night tonight? Did you enjoy the first in the video series? Did you enjoy it? I hope you did. And did you enjoy the music we played? And how about that Lester Roadhog Moran and his Cadillac? You got to do it like that, Cadillac Cowboys. Funny stuff. Okay, mark your calendars. Tuesday, next Tuesday. So it's Tuesday, October 6th, 7 p.m. Central, 8 p.m. Eastern, the second of the seven-part series with Don Reid of the Statler Brothers. And share this. Share the first video with Don, which is just underneath this one on my Facebook page. Share them both, and I would appreciate that. And we will call it a night. So now, let's see. What did I say, Thursday? Either tomorrow night, I'll be back on live again. We won't be doing the Statler Brothers stuff, but we'll be doing something else, maybe playing some trivia games, or I'll get another one of my pieces of memorabilia out, and we'll play some music surrounding that. And then sometime Saturday, could be coming back your way, probably Saturday afternoon. So you don't have to wait till Tuesday. We'll have fun again either tomorrow night and or Saturday. So join us, okay? That's it for tonight. God bless you all.